Talking to myself and feeling old. Sometimes I'd like to quit. Nothing ever seems to fit. Hanging around, nothing to do but frown. Rainy days and Mondays always get me down. What I've got they used to call the blues. Nothing is really wrong. Feeling like I don't belong. Walking around some kind of lonely clown. Rainy days and Mondays always get me down. Funny, but it seems I always wind up here with you. Nice to know somebody loves me. Funny, but it seems that it's the only thing to do. Run and find the one who loves me. What I feel is come and gone before. No need to talk it out. We know what it's all about.
Because your father got a better job. And so Richard could be a superstar.
I wouldn't count on it, Rich.
Why not? You don't think I got the talent?
I think you're the most talented musician there is.
Then why not?
Because you just dropped your piano.
I better run, because I'm going to get you!
Oh, hey! Dad, way to go!
I get the ropes now, son.
You sure are making up for last Saturday night.
I think you're being very unfair, Harold.
What?
Well, wasting your time as a printer when you could be making a fortune bowling for a living.
Yeah, Dad, join the tour.
I think what we need is a little reinforcement. You kids want some hot dogs?
Yeah, you bet.
Here, Richard.
Thanks, Mom.
Look after your sister.
Okay.
Come on!
All right, wait up.
You know, I'm worried about Karen. She had so many friends back home.
She's only 13. She'll adjust.
Well, at least Richard's got the job at the church.
Yeah, but every time he plays that organ, Karen's right there. You gotta admit, not many 16-year-olds would let their kid sister tag along.
Maybe we raise them right.
Thank you.
Here's my sister Karen singing The End of the World.
Hogging the trophy.
I still can't believe you won it.
Well, you can see it in the living room.
No, Richard, don't take it.
Mom says we're gonna fill the whole place with awards someday.
You maybe.
Hey, listen.
I've been taking piano lessons since I was 12 years old. If you'd find an instrument and stick to it, maybe we could be a team.
Yeah, right.
Why not?
Because you're the one with all the talent.
I know. Doesn't it bug you?
Ha ha, very funny.
You're not bad, you know.
You really think so?
Yeah, you just gotta work on it.
You really think we could be a team?
Well, sure. Of course, I'm the senior member.
Okay.
Great, then I get the pizza.
No, Richard, it's mine.
Come on, you said
Richard,
I was in charge.
No, not about my pizza.
I'm doing you a favor. In 10 or 20 years, Mom or Dad are gonna let you date. You don't wanna get fat, do you?
All right, people, take five.
Hey, Frankie, wait up. Sure looks like fun playing the drum.
Oh, yeah, and kind of noisy, though.
Can I try?
Kidding?
No, I mean it. How do you hold these things? Yeah.
How does that feel?
Great.
Karen?
Is this wrong?
No. I was just, you know, I was kind of wondering if maybe you would want to go to the dance with me this weekend.
Oh, I'm not much of a dancer.
Well, we wouldn't have to dance. We could just watch. Or, we could skip the dance and just get some burgers.
Tell you what, you let me play the drum for the rest of practice, and I'll go with you. Deal?
Said yes.
Really? Oh, you're the best!
You can play drums in the band and you don't have to take gym.
You're amazing. You can do anything.
You got the toughest part.
What?
Convincing Mom and Dad.
Well, why not, Mom? I'm really serious this time.
You were also serious about the flute and the accordion.
And they're in the attic.
Oh, the dumb accordion was your idea.
Well, the drums are not my idea of an instrument suitable for a young lady.
Well, why not?
Well, how many famous women drummers do you know?
So I'll be the first.
Dad, if you borrow some drums, I can line up a bass player.
Yeah.
And then we can have a trio.
Yeah, how about that?
Well, what do you think, dear?
I don't know. I never pictured my daughter playing the drums.
Oh, Mom.
All right, Rich, you take it the rest of the way.
You always said that we could do anything if we believed in it enough. And I really believe in this. I'll stick with this. I'll practice every day. And I just know I can do this, Mom. I know I can play the drums.
Thank you. Battle of the Bands for 1966 is the Richard Carpenter Trio!
Hey, Joe, wait a minute. We won the Hollywood Battle of the Bands. I mean, come on.
Well, that was with a jazz instrumental, wasn't it? I'm looking for vocals, something a little more mainstream.
Well, great. I've been working on some top 40 material. My sister can sing.
All right, I'm listening.
What are you doing? We haven't rehearsed anything.
Fake it.
All of my life in E.
Wait, I'm sorry. It was my fault. Wrong key. Let's try again. In A this time. Ready? And.
All of my life I have been waiting for just one boy. And all of my life I
I'm sorry, is there a problem?
Well, this recording contract is for Karen.
Well, you know, your daughter has a one in a million voice, Mrs. Carpenter.
You mean you want to sign Karen without Richard?
No way.
Well, maybe we could work something out.
Absolutely not.
Listen, you guys, this is what we've been working for. It's a great opportunity for
no,
Karen.
No, Richard, we're a team.
Don't worry about it.
Rich, Magic Lamp is a small label. I just don't even have the budget to...
Our family sticks together. Richard and Karen performed
here. Mom, it's okay. I'll play backup.
No, Richard, you can't.
Karen...
I won't have my family torn apart.
Mom, what difference does it make as long as there's a Carpenter on the label?
Richard does have a point, Agnes.
Well...
Well, it's settled.
Well, I guess so.
Oh, actually, I forgot you're underage, so I'm gonna have to have one of your parents sign the contract. Well, somebody congratulate me. I just signed Harold Carpenter.
That's it. Great. Perfect. Let's do it together.
got it?
Uh-huh. Yeah, but Rich, there are only two of us. How are you gonna make
it sound? See, I've been working on this idea of multi-harmony overdubbing. Joe has a four-track board at a studio, and we can get the sound we want by ping-ponging.
Could you say that in English now, please?
Yeah. See, it'll sound like there are a lot of voices on the record, but you and I will be doing all the parts. You'll be singing the lead, and we'll both be doing the harmony like this.
Don't be afraid to love and get love returned. Don't be afraid to tell everyone you've loved that love is a groovy thing. It knows how to make you sing, and it fills up your life with sunshine and days you find that's the way to live, and living is what we all were put on this earth to do. So come on and live and be happy. Don't be afraid to love.
Richie, stop it!
Joe says you gotta have a picture for the record jacket.
No, I'm too fat.
Well, if you don't get off that water diet, you're gonna drown.
Take it in my face. Don't leave me alone.
Oh, that's a good angle.
Stop it!
Okay, folks, we got it.
Guys, I have some bad news. Magic Lamp's out of business.
What?
Well, my partner and I are busted. But you guys can continue using the studio. And I think, you know, with Karen's vocals and Rich, your new sound, you guys have a shot. That's the music business. I mean, small labels usually have a lot of trouble getting major distribution. And I got news for you. These days, it takes a minor miracle to get a new record on the radio.
So finally, after all this time, everyone says the equipment here is supposed to be out of sight. I can't wait to get my hands on that board.
Did Charlie Chaplin really own this place?
Well, that's what they say.
God, I can't believe Herb Alpert heard our tape and liked it.
Yeah, but it still came down to a friend of a friend of a friend to get us in here. This business is crazy.
Hey, you think he's gonna be here today?
Well, I don't know. He might want to come by the studio and check on his investment.
Sounds good, Roger. How's it going?
Hey, Herb. Just a few more overdubs, and we're done with this tune.
I like Richard's arrangements. And that voice.
Herb, she's a dream. She never makes a mistake. Neither one of them do. Notice how her image saddens. How lonely she's become. Just once I'd like.
It's nice, but it's not right for me. Maybe Richard and Karen can do something with it. There's a charity thing in a couple of months. They might want to try it out there.
I'll see that Richard gets it.
See you later, Roger.
So they sprinkled moon dust in your hair?
What, is he kidding?
So they sprinkled moon dust in your hair, a golden starlight in your eyes of blue. That is why all the girls in town follow you all around. Just like me, they long to be close to you.
take a short break and we'll be right back.
Can you believe who's here?
Glenn Campbell, Burt Bacharach.
I know, Mom would die if she saw these
this
people.
This estate
in
one place. Is huge.
I know. What do you think they have in the bathroom?
I don't know, but you can't go now. Look who's coming.
Herb, hi. I'll be right back.
Nice,
sir. Hi, Herb. Thanks. Good to see you.
I'd like you to meet my manager, Sherwin Bash.
Hi.
Sherwin, wonderful. Nice to meet you.
And his associate, Ted Newman.
It's a great hi. Sound.
Thank you. Thank you.
Herb tells me you're looking for representation.
Oh, excuse me.
Hi. I was hoping I'd meet you. I'm Lucy, Ted Newman's wife. You have the most beautiful voice.
Thank you.
Excuse me. Oh, my feet are killing me. I get so used to wearing sneakers all day that when we have to come to one of these show and tells, oh, wearing heels is torture.
I love your dress.
Thank you.
Where'd you get it?
God, I don't remember. Saks, Magnans, somewhere in Beverly Hills.
We've been rehearsing so much that I haven't had any time to go shopping. My mother bought most of my clothes.
Well, if you've ever got a free afternoon, I'll take you shopping. I love to shop.
Really? I would like that.
Good.
Okay. I'll see you later.
Okay.
Karen. Karen.
Richard, you wouldn't believe
what has four legs, loads of talent, and the best managers in town?
Us? Us?
Yes!
Can't you sleep?
I could never sleep.
Your kids are doing so well, but I'm worried that you're not getting enough rest.
Go back to bed, Mom. I don't want to keep you up.
Is there something wrong?
Oh, it's kind of hard to explain. See, I go to bed, and I try to sleep. But then I start going over everything in my head, and it makes me crazy. I mean, I know that we've got something special. But we finally get somebody to listen to us, and they like us. And then it's even worse because you're not sure if they're going to keep liking you, liking the music. I don't know, does that make any sense?
What you need is what the doctor gave me to help me sleep.
First.
Shh. What?
I gotta call Ted.
You want to do commercials?
No, Mom, the song. I want to record it.
Richard, it's 2:00 in the morning.
I know, but Mom, listen, that song could be a hit.
Here, take one of these.
What is it?
Something called Quaaludes to help you sleep.
Sounds great, Rich. I just need to adjust the kick mic. What do you think?
I like it. I like it a lot.
And it's a bank commercial.
Yeah, I'll bet every record executive and musician in L.A. has heard it 100 times. Kid's got an ear.
Karen, Richard, we love it. Let's track it.
Well, I wish I had known you were coming.
I'm sorry.
Oh, no, I didn't mean that.
No, no, it's my fault. I got so excited, I just rushed right over. I should have waited for my husband to introduce me.
No, well, come on in and have some coffee.
Thanks. Do you think Richard and Karen will be home soon?
Yes, I'm expecting them any minute. Is anything wrong?
Oh, no. In fact, it's very good news.
In this week's Top 100, Close to You is number 7.
Number 7?
But just 2 weeks ago, it was number 56.
Ted is certain it's going to be number one.
In the whole country?
Isn't that fantastic?
Oh, my heavens. I never dreamed.
Oh, I guess you'll be moving out of this place pretty soon, huh? I mean, What's that?
We're number seven! Can you believe it?
You can't stop that racket. The neighbors are going to call the police.
Oh, who cares?
Karen! Look at these reviews of our concert. They are fabulous.
Great. I use
this.
Right,
Karen?
Yes.
That's what didn't I tell you?
You called me. I should have believed you.
Congratulations.
Hi.
What in the world is going on here? The people all over the place.
Dad, close to you. Number seven on the chart.
Can you believe it?
Mr. Carpenter, I think it's safe to say your son and daughter are properly launched.
Straight to the top.
What do you think of that, doll? That's wonderful.
Come on, let's go in and celebrate.
Congratulations.
Oh, my hands are all dirty. Can you put a show together in 2 weeks?
2 weeks?
Yeah. That's when you open in Tahoe. I don't know. Karen, what do you think?
This chubby sister.
Where there's room to grow, and yes, we've just begun.
They got the number one record in the country. So what if they're new? Now they're to the Carson Show on the 23rd. We'll clear the 24th for you, but I want the Civic Auditorium, not that big hard on camp.
Hold it! Mark, we need a little more snap in the kick. Let's take it from the top of the song one more time, please.
Talk about love, how it makes life complete. You can talk all you want.
Okay, that's great. Mark, a little more high end in Karen's mic. Karen, could you check the MC mic up front, please?
Talk about love, how it makes life complete. You can talk all you want, make it sound good and sweet. But the words have an empty ring, then they don't really mean a thing. Without love, you are not to be found.
You are not to be found.
You can shout, we're all brothers.
Right, okay, I gotta go and see on the 24th.
But you can't cover up the past, just pretend you will never last. Without love, you are nothing at all.
You are nothing at all. For love, yes, surrender. You must surrender if you can.
Look at her.
You must
where she belongs.
Yeah, not for Minor's damn drums.
But the question is, how do you get Linus to give up his blanket?
You must surrender if you can.
would you just think about it?
I have thought about it, and my answer is no.
You're too good to be hiding behind those drums.
Hiding? Who says I'm hiding?
Nobody can see you.
I'm the drummer. Where else am I supposed to be?
Out front.
I wouldn't feel right.
But it would look right.
Karen's audiences love you, and they want to be able to see
Isn't
you.
Isn't anybody listening to me? I said no.
You're already out there singing. What's the difference?
There's a big difference. Richard, tell them.
It was my idea.
Karen, wait.
Richard's only thinking of you.
I thought you wanted to be a star.
Long ago and oh so far away, I fell in love with you before the second show.
So anyway, everybody keeps pushing me to do it, so I think on the next tour I'm going to try a few songs out front.
It's going to be great.
You know, yeah, but every time I think that, I get such butterflies.
So I'd be a nurse.
Karen, you're not eating.
Well, I'm just excited about being home. Besides, I'm watching my weight.
Well, you look wonderful. I'll bet on that tour you have all those fellows beating down your door.
You're
your
right,
schedule,
Dad.
You've got to eat.
I am you've eating, aren't I, RC?
Yeah.
Who's RC?
She calls me RC, I call her Casey. We started it on tour.
Oh.
Seems to me you've come up with several habits. Maybe some not so healthy.
We ought to get after Richard. He's the one who spends every night watching TV until all hours.
I do not.
Are you still not sleeping? Are you taking those pills I gave you, those Quaalude things?
Mom, you better watch your supply. Richard's turning into a drug fiend.
They're not drugs. They're prescription medicine. Richard's under a lot of stress.
Yeah, from beating all the guys away from Karen's door.
Oh, right.
I don't know what's gotten into you two. You look too thin, if you ask me.
Mother, how can anybody be too thin? Women are supposed to be thin now.
Be sensible about it for
once. I am being sensible.
You don't know what it's like being up there with the spotlight on you. They can see every pound. And they don't just review our music. They review our hair and they review our clothes. Remember that one article and they called me chubby?
Oh, come on, that was 100 years ago.
Yeah, but they
Nobody
still look
can
for
call
things
you
like
chubby
that.
Now. Harold Teller.
Oh, you look fine. But we wouldn't want you to lose any more, kiddo.
Lucy. What is going on? Where's Karen?
She just wants to look her best, Rowan. She'll only be a minute.
A minute? She used that up an hour ago. Look, this is serious. They're going crazy out there.
Relax, you guys. Everything will be fine.
Please tell Miss Perfect there's 10,000 people waiting for her.
Yes, sir. Come
out
there.
2 minutes.
Karen, you about ready?
Yeah, come in.
Oh, look at you. You look beautiful.
Think so? I think this dress makes me look fat.
Are you kidding? You make me look fat.
But I'm about to become an expert in that department. No, the rabbit died.
Oh, I hate you. Come here.
Everything I want, a good man and now a baby. It's wonderful.
You will too, kid. I mean, come on, get out of there.
I have that
Karen,
dress.
Go
Maybe
sing.
Make
no, right now. Come on.
I've been so many places in my life and time. That silent sounds that make somebody mine. I've acted out my love in stages with 10,000 people watching.
I love you, Karen!
But we're alone now and I'm singing this song for you. I know your image of me is what I hope to be. I've treated you unkindly, but darling, can't you see? There's no one more important to me. Darling, can't you please see through me? We're alone now and I'm singing this song for you. Precious secrets of a truth withholding nothing. You came out in front and I was hiding. But now I'm so much better, and if my words don't come together, listen to the melody.
'Cause my love.
No space or time. I love you for my life. You are a friend of mine.
And when my life is over, remember when we were together.
We were alone and I was singing a song for you.
Mom, you wouldn't have believed it. It was so exciting. I was really nervous, but I walked out and the audience was terrific. They were so warm. No, he's right here.
Hi, Mom.
I'm in Richard's room. We're watching TV. Yes, I'm eating. Don't worry. Okay, we'll call you tomorrow.
Goodbye, Mom.
Give Daddy our love. Okay, bye.
Want some?
In a minute.
Hey, could you turn on the TV for me? Thanks.
You know, Mom knew I wouldn't have any problems tonight.
She was right.
Yeah, but how does she know? You know, just once I wish she would say, a platinum album, kids. That's amazing. Or how many people were in that audience? That's a lot of people. But instead, it's like she expects it, you know? Does that drive you crazy?
Mom's mom. She believes in us. I thought you were going to share this with me.
Well, I'm too keyed up.
So have a quaalude. It'll relax you.
You take too many of those things.
Now you sound like Mom. You know, you didn't have to babysit me. You should have gone out.
No. I love Lucy, but she's always trying to fix me up, you know? You know that all the guys care about is, like, say they've been with a rock star or something stupid like that. I'm never gonna find somebody who just wants me.
Yeah, you will. Someday.
Yeah. We're never in one place long enough. I can just see it now. I'll have a cottage in Connecticut and the station wagon and the kids, and my husband will wear those plaid flannel shirts, you know, the red ones with the black lines on them.
What are you gonna have?
Shirts?
No, kids.
Oh. I don't know, at least two. If my husband's really cute, I don't know, how would you feel, Richard, about being the uncle to about 12 kids? Rich?
Look at this. When did you pick up this beauty?
This morning. Do you like it?
You know I love these 59 Furies.
Well, Dad, this 59 Fury has got your name on it.
Oh, no. No, no, kids, no. Come on, no. You just bought us the house. Come on,
we love
no.
You.
Oh,
what else
no.
are we supposed to do with our money, huh?
Oh.
Save it. No, it's boring.
Oh,
wait.
Agnes, look at this.
Mom. We didn't forget about you.
Heavens.
Would you look at that?
What on earth?
We found it in this incredible store in Tokyo.
Oh, my.
It must have cost a fortune.
It's beautiful, Mom. Try it on.
You're worth it, Mom.
Let me help.
What?
Does it have sleeves?
Yeah, it
it's like a maze
sleeves.
Getting in that thing, isn't it?
Feels like silk.
It is silk, Dad.
There you go.
Karen, it's so sweet of you.
Oh.
But where am I ever going to wear something like this?
Well, anywhere. Wear it around the house if you want.
Oh, Karen.
Oh, it's beautiful on you, Mom.
Well, I think you should have asked me.
I'm sorry. I
but it's
you'd...
lovely.
Really?
Well, now, come on. I've just been dying to show you around the house.
Oh, yes.
You're going to be surprised when you see how much we've done since you left. You won't believe it.
Really?
I thought this room at the top of the stairs on the right would be best for you, Karen. And the one across the hall would be yours, Richard.
What's the matter, kiddo?
Karen, don't you want to see your room?
Oh, Mom, you don't expect us to live with you forever, do you?
Well, no, not forever. When you get married, you'll have your own home.
Mom, we're not little kids anymore.
You know, one time I told that Lucy friend of yours that when you and Richard made a lot of money, you wouldn't lose your basic values. I hope I wasn't wrong.
Mom, stop it. I'm 24 years old. Don't make me feel guilty for wanting to move away from home.
Karen, I think if you took a look at the room your mother fixed up for you, you'll find there aren't any bars on the window.
Daddy, that's not the
point. Besides, it's not like you'll be in town all that much.
Mom. What Karen means is that we've been thinking about sharing a house of our own. Here in Downey, maybe.
Here in Downey?
Yeah.
Why didn't you say so? Harold, I don't think we'd have any objection to that, do you?
No, not at all.
Well, come on up and look anyway.
Okay.
You know our neighbors, the Batemans?
Yeah. Down the street?
Uh-huh. Their nephew is a real estate agent, and I know he could be a big
help. He is.
Well, she got her daddy's car and she cruised in the hamburger stand now.
Kenny is wonderful.
She forgot all about the library, but she told her all that now.
No, I...
And with the radio playing, she goes to the hamburger stand now. And she'll have fun, 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 fun,
heroin. We were starting to wonder what happened to you.
Well, you lived in Brentwood where you belong. Maybe I could find this place. Rich, Rin.
It's nice to meet you. Come on in. Sherwin, you never told me your daughter was this pretty.
Now, why do you think you were stashed in an Eastern college?
Oh, yeah, no kidding. I'm originally from Connecticut.
I know.
She's a big fan of you.
Daddy, this is for your house.
Thank you. Sherwin, you made it.
Yeah, you found it.
Ready.
Hey, so, Dad. Carpenter, where's the vino? If I have to drink iced tea,
there is some of that great 1970 Chardonnay in the refrigerator. It's right around the corner.
Show where I'm good idea.
Clock. That is perfect.
You like it?
Yes, it's great. Thank you so much.
If you tell me that he's got a great personality, it's a pass.
He's got a great personality.
He's a bon vivant.
Bon vivant.
Well, he's going to tell me bon voyage when he finds out that I like to bowl.
Karen, just give him a chance. He's fantastic. Look, he's in New York now. I want him to call you as soon as he gets back. His name's Peter Howard, and Sherwin's thinking of hiring him.
Lucy, thanks, but no thanks. No one in the business just buys you trouble.
I don't think Richard would mind. Getting back to the point, he's not married, he's not gay, and he doesn't want your money. He's not a gold digger. He's got his own. So, what excuses can you come up with now?
Okay, I'll go. But I don't have to like it.
Every day.
Good night. Had a really nice time. Thanks, Peter.
Karen, this isn't our first day, and it might have come to your attention that I'm in love with you. So, Miss Carpenter, I was wondering, are you ever going to invite me in for milk and cookies?
You grow so deep inside of me. You're
oops. Forget your bowling ball.
And you're the one I love. All my life,
Rich, you're out of iced tea. Do you want something else?
No, it's okay. I'm kind of sleepy. I think I'm just gonna crash. Why don't you come on up?
Oh, you're home early.
Hey, Pete, Casey, how was the bowling?
It was fine, Rich.
Good night. See you in the morning.
Would you mind if I...
No, that's okay.
I'm really sorry.
I'll call you tomorrow.
I want her out of here.
My house, too, remember?
You're practically living together. It's not fair to me.
What are you so upset about?
Last night?
What happened last night?
Damn well what happened last night.
What?
Oh, my God, Richard. I don't care what Mom says, you have to get off those quaaludes.
Now, just hold on a minute. Before you start lecturing me, you want to talk about you?
What about me?
Well, all you eat is salads, you skip meals, you don't take care of yourself. And what about those little boxes of laxatives up in your medicine cabinet?
I don't know about those. Was she sniffing through my cabinets?
No, I found them.
And I bet you told her, too. That is exactly what I am talking about, Richard. I have no privacy in my
house. Well, maybe we both need a little more privacy.
Fine. I'll move out tomorrow.
Karen, wait. Wait, we're a team, remember?
Not anymore. Not in this house.
Yeah.
Karen, over here. Hi.
Hi, pumpkin.
He's gotten so big.
How are you? You look gorgeous.
Thank you, so do you. It's not fair, Lucy. You have two now. Can't you spare one?
As much as I love you, no.
In a couple of years, you will have.
Oh, if you tell me one more time that my turn will come, I'm going to bark.
I'm sorry we had to start without you. Let's get you something.
No, I'm not even hungry.
Karen.
I had a huge breakfast. Promise. Listen, when we're finished here, I want you to come back to my condo. I'm redoing the entire place, right down to the wallpaper.
Has your mother picked out the pattern yet? You will never guess who I saw last night. Peter. He's grown a beard and he looks so cute. I'm sorry it didn't work out.
So am I. You know how those things go. He tried, I tried. Can't you eat any faster?
We'll go a lot faster if you'd help me.
Let's go. I'm dying to show you this place.
Oh, Karen, it's beautiful.
Thanks.
I love this color.
This is what I really wanted to show you. On this wall, I want to put that one big Japanese print I was telling you
about. That'd be fantastic.
Mother, what are you still doing here? I thought you had a hair appointment.
Oh, I just wanted to finish up.
Hi, Mrs. Carpenter.
Hi, Lucy. The baby's grown so much.
I wanted to show Lucy what I was doing with the place.
Karen, can I talk to you a second?
Sure.
You'll excuse us, won't you?
Sure.
There's some juice for him in the fridge.
Okay. Come on, sweetheart. Come on, Jason. Let's get you some juice, okay? Okay, baby.
What are these?
You've been going through my things?
No. I was cleaning out the bathroom cupboard for the painters. What are these for?
They're nothing. They were from some old diet that I was on.
But why? Why would a grown, healthy woman need suppositories and laxatives?
They were just part of this one diet.
You're still using these, aren't you?
No. No, Mother, they're old. I just forgot to throw them out. I'm going to put them in the trash right
now. You remember what those doctors said? You haven't gained any weight that I see.
Are you kidding, Mother? I am fat.
You are not fat. Now, I just want to see under your shirt. Let me see.
Down to
see. You have carried this too far. If you don't start eating, you're going to make yourself sick. Now, a person can't live this way. It's not right.
No, no, you don't. Why do you get after Richard? He pops those quaaludes like they're candy.
Does not. You're just.
You have no idea.
I do. And I know that you kids are under a lot of pressure, but that doesn't
you think
mean
you can just what the problem. If I just listen to you, then everything is going to work out for the best.
Is that so wrong? Wanting what's best for my children?
Not always what's best for me.
I know that everybody has problems. Your father and I have had many, many.
Please spare me the speech I've heard a zillion times. Just stay out of my personal life. You are smothering me. I know that you mean well, and I love you for it. But you have got to let me live my own life. You have just got to.
Karen! Will you promise me you're not going to use those things anymore?
I am not using them.
Promise.
I am not using them. Will you please trust me?
I just want you to be happy. That's all I ever wanted.
I know, Mom. I know. I have to go.
sister is 35 pounds underweight.
But she'll be all right.
Well, we're going to keep her here for a little while just to make sure. How'd she get so thin?
I don't know. Nobody can make her eat.
Is she on drugs?
No, absolutely not. We're on tour all the time, and we work all day and night, and sometimes it gets crazy.
Deb sends her love. I forgot to say I called it.
Oh, good morning.
Good
morning.
Lovely.
Oh.
About these.
Thank you, Richard.
Karen, how are you feeling?
Very well, thank you. Much better. They're beautiful.
I see you're eating.
Oh, yeah, lots. So when do I get to go home?
We'd like to see you gain a little weight first.
Oh, I will.
She always says that.
No, I mean it. I'll gain 5-10 pounds. I'll be fine.
Make sure that you do.
Thank you, doctor.
Hey, you guys, I'm just a little tired, you know? We had a killer tour this summer, and then Las Vegas.
What you need is a good long rest.
That's just what you do need.
And that's exactly what I'm going to do. As soon as we get home from Europe and Japan, I'm going to just do nothing but sleep all the time.
Karen, the doctors don't think you ought to go.
What do you mean? We have to go. We're already booked. We've got no choice.
They're the experts. You have to listen to them.
Rich?
Karen. We're canceling.
What? This is ridiculous. I've never missed a concert before. You can't
be
serious.
It'll be fine. I'm gonna go over and I'm
without me?
Well, yeah, just to Japan. We set some press conferences up, you know, to explain why we're not there.
Sherwin's not going to like this at all.
Well, the important thing is
have you talked to him about it?
Sherwin's not our manager anymore.
What? Why is it that I'm always told after the decision is made? Doesn't anyone ever care what I might think?
Wait,
I mean, I'm half of this team,
Casey,
Richard.
It's no big deal. Sherwin and Ted are splitting, and that's all there is to it. I thought you'd be happy we worked it out so easily.
Does this mean you won't be seeing Randy anymore?
Love, look at the two.
Operated under strictest confidentiality.
Oh, good. You can throw out that disguise that you bought yourself.
How long do I have to stay?
6 weeks.
6 weeks? Really? I don't know the last time you and I spent more than a week before.
I can't have visitors, right?
Sure. Look, make yourself comfortable. I'm going to go get some paperwork, and I'll be right back. All right?
Okay.
Oh.
Don't worry. I'll come visit you every week.
So, what are you gonna do, sweetheart, while I'm in the pen?
you and I haven't discussed this. And maybe now's not the greatest time to bring it up, but Ted and I were talking, and we're thinking about going into the studio and recording some stuff.
Without me?
Richard, nothing said. It was just
an idea. Right, it's not. I don't want you soloing. I've worked a long time perfecting our sound.
Look, I'm sorry for bringing it up. I didn't even know
this
that
is
you
great.
Would feel this way.
This is great. I get sick and volunteer to come in this place, and 5 minutes later, you're ready to jump ship.
Richard,
I
am not jumping ship.
There's nothing wrong with the way we've always done things.
Of course there isn't.
I'd say it's worked pretty damn well, so just don't mess with it, all right?
Okay, fine.
Wait. Karen, come here. I'm sorry. Sit down. Sit. It's just that getting sick and admitting that I'm screwed up is kind of hard. Do you know what I mean?
Richard, you're not screwed up. Yeah. You're gonna be as good as new.
I know. So what about you?
What about me?
Come on, Karen, you know what I mean. You were supposed to be getting better by now. You're still so thin. Now look, you've got some time. Maybe if you went back in the hospital or saw somebody, I don't know, anything, just try, please. Come on, a couple of months, we'll both be so much better. We'll be strong like we used to be. Things will start happening for us again. Don't you want that?
Of course I do.
So it's definite then. We got a deal?
Yeah. So who is this guy anyway?
Oh, he's just a friend. But he'll make a great-looking senator. Oh, I see. Honey, you didn't have to come, but I'd love you for it. Thanks.
Oh, it's no problem.
It's going great.
Better than staying at home. So what do you want me to do?
I want you to have a good time and be your happy, perky, cheerful, sunny self, okay? Be right back.
Hi.
Hi.
You're one of the organizers, right?
No.
Oh, campaign manager?
No, why?
Well, I wanted to leave a check with somebody, and you look like you were in charge.
Really?
Hi, I'm Bob Knight.
Karen Carpenter.
Hi, Karen. So, do you work for the senator at all?
No. Have you ever heard of the Carpenters?
I have a whole crew of them on staff. I develop real estate. What about you? What do you do?
I'm a singer.
What do you sing?
I don't believe this. Love songs, mostly.
Do you think that maybe I could get you to sing one for me sometime?
Karen? Karen! I have to go. Will you excuse me?
Okay, but just for the time being, Miss Carpenter, because we've only just begun.
Let's go away.
And no matter how hard I try to understand the reason why we carry on this way, we're lost in this
recording. I'm doing some TV show. These promotional tours and photographs and PR. I just get exhausted. I've got nothing left to give to
him. If it was meant to be, none of that would matter. You know, Dad and I went through some very difficult times.
Oh, Mother, nobody could possibly have the kind of relationship that you and Daddy have. I can't live up to that.
Karen, all we want is for you to be happy.
I am happy, really.
Are you?
Yes.
Karen, I know that we taught you that when you get married, it's for life.
And it is.
Honey, I cannot stand to see you in so much pain. You've got to take better care of yourself.
Karen, I never thought I would say this, but we think you and Bob ought to get a divorce.
Casey, you don't have any other choice.
Stop it! You're all ganging up on me.
You're not ganging up on me.
It's my life.
Yeah, and you're throwing it away.
Well, how can you even say that, Richard? You never liked him.
Karen, the point is that we love you.
You're treating me like a two-year-old. That's not love!
Wait, we didn't mean to hurt you. It's okay.
Some of us.
It's all right. I know.
And children and the family.
Oh, my God. Karen, what's happening? You've wasted away. Wait, come here. Come here. You've got to listen to me. You've got to get help. Please.
As you know, Karen volunteered for treatment. I think it's a very positive first step.
Well, Mr. Latimer, you know, we've been after her for years. We've tried everything to get her to eat.
I understand. Please make yourselves comfortable.
Mr. Latimer, this thing you say Karen has, what's it called?
It's called anorexia nervosa. Please. We're just starting to learn more about it, but in plain English, it's self-starvation.
Why would anyone do that?
It's a psychological disorder. Can I get anyone something to drink?
Nothing
juice
for me,
or coffee?
Yeah, juice would be great, thank you.
Okay.
Mr. Latimer, if this is a psychological disorder, then there must be a reason for it. How did my sister get so sick?
Well, initially, when a young woman like Karen starts losing weight, everybody starts telling her she looks great.
I know I've done that.
Well, it's only natural. Here you go.
But you're saying it was bad to
thank
do
you.
No, I'm not saying that. It's just that when she gets all that kind of attention, compliments, it encourages her to lose more weight. She diets and she exercises.
and uses laxatives and diuretics.
Yes, exactly. And after a while, there's a chemical change that takes place in her body, and she actually begins to feel good. So the pattern of abuse continues until she stops, or someone stops her.
Seems to me what you're saying is we didn't do a good job raising our daughter.
No, that's not what I'm saying. But I think you should be aware that in conversations that I've had with Karen, I got the sense that she felt she didn't have any control of her life, especially since the divorce. She couldn't do anything for herself.
Except lose weight?
Exactly. That she can control. At least, she thinks she can.
But if it's all in her head, who's to blame? Us, I suppose.
Agnes, we're not here to point the finger at anybody. We're just here to help Karen.
Young man, I'm not accustomed to people half my age calling me by my first name. And I'm perfectly aware of
that. I didn't mean to offend you.
And you might as well know that I don't put much stock in this psychiatry business either.
I'm sorry you feel that way, Mrs. Carpenter, but Karen has decided to come to me, and I think that's a commitment on her part to get well.
That's the important thing, Mom.
Now, the more cooperation I can get from your family, the more progress Karen can make. Would you call Karen down, please?
Right away.
Now, there's one more thing. We have found a common element in all the patients that suffer from anorexia. The fear that if they don't live up to the family's expectations, they're not going to be loved.
Are you saying that we don't love Karen?
No. But have you told her that you love her?
Well, naturally
we don't do things that way. You show a person, you don't tell them all the time.
Would it hurt to try?
I don't think you understand our family.
Hey, Squirt.
Hi.
Karen, come on in. Carpenter. Go ahead.
Well, for heaven's sake, this is ridiculous. We came 3,000 miles for this nonsense. We don't need to prove anything to Karen. She knows we love her.
Autumn days, lying on a bed of leaves, watching clouds up through the trees. He said our love was more than time. It's colder now, the trees are bare. Can't get warm since you've been gone. Can't stop singing sad songs. Where do I go from here? Tell me, where do I go?
Dr. Lee.
Here?
Oh, hi, babe. How's that favorite singer doing today?
Well, our TV's on the first. With the fuss she made this morning, you'd have thought we'd cut off the air supply.
That's great. At least she's standing up for herself.
Right.
And run an update on those charts we're going to have this afternoon.
I'll do that, Dr. Lee.
Karen's been talking more lately about wanting to go home. I told her we'd try to get her there by Thanksgiving. Her weight's up to 104.
Well, the big question is, will she be able to maintain it?
She wants to try. She's anxious to get back into the studio again. I think it'd be good for her.
Hey, she's been undernourished for a long time.
Now, on the other hand, we can't keep her here forever.
Hi, guys.
Hi,
Richard. Hi, Mom. So, how do I look?
Fine, just fine.
Wonderful.
Rich.
You look good. You look really good.
Yeah, And I got a little belly.
Yeah, but that's great.
That's great. I feel good. I really do. I'm ready to go back to work, too.
No, come on. Let's not talk about that right now.
You'll have to take it easy for a while.
Daddy, I've been vegetating for a really long time.
Here, let me take this,
honey. No, I'm fine, really.
Are you sure, Karen? Richard, you take this.
No, wait, you guys. I'm fine, really. Strong as an ox. Listen, tomorrow, will you call the... Call her. Call everyone you know and just tell them that Karen Carpenter is back in town.
The winds might blow through me, but I don't care. There's no harm in fun, not if you are there. And now when you touch my feelings fly, now
that was perfect. Thanks a lot, guys. That's a wrap.
Karen, it's fine, believe me. You got to me again, babe.
It's gold, Karen. Pure gold.
Wait, Rich, it's not that late. I'd love to do it again.
Come on, you're tired. Let's go. It's done.
Rich, I'm not tired.
Come on, we'll do it again tomorrow.
Wait a minute, Richard, I'm
Let's
serious.
Let's just go home to work. Come on.
You were such a pain in the neck.
You were great.
Why do I even listen to you?
I'm not very good at saying grace, but Heavenly Father, thank you for bringing us all together again, for bringing our little girl home to us, and for making her well. You can't know how much this means. Well, you probably do know. Anyway, thank you. Amen.
It was beautiful, Harold.
Thanks, Tammy.
All right.
Okay, big load of mashed potatoes.
Someone's for me.
I'll need to get some dark meat trimmed up here. I'll have faint.
Dad.
Dear Rich, this is your favorite.
Yes, right. Every year I look forward to eating this stuffing.
Oh, yes, that's your favorite.
Yes, Dad.
This is my favorite.
Thank you.
All right.
What were you looking at? You think I'm not going to eat? Well,
I'm just worried there's not going to be any left for me. That's what I'm worried about.
There isn't. I'm telling you. No leftovers this year. Can you hand me the stuff?
Yes.
You ought to get some sleep.
Yeah, I know. It's getting late. It's been a long day. It's been a long year. Dad, would you and Mom mind if I spent the night here? I don't feel like driving back to my condo.
Of course not.
We were hoping you would.
Oh, great. Okay, then I'll see you in the AM.
Good night, kiddo.
Good night. Good night, Mom.
Night. Karen, I just wanted to say, I know you're going to be needing some new clothes, and I was just wondering if you'd like to go shopping, just you and me.
Yeah, I'd love to. Do you want to go tomorrow?
Fine.
Okay, great.
And Karen, I love you.
I love you too, Mom. Good night.
Have you a place where there's no space or time? I love you, fall in my life. You are a friend of mine.